rely on entertainment. Rely on entertainment. Keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye, keep it an eye on entertainment.
And Ron, do you have your little ghost radar with you?
Yeah.
Okay, I want to show everybody something. This is really
cool.
Oh
my gosh!
Yeah.
This is cool. This works by...
Watch this.
This works by magnetic fields. And it actually works. It was made by Sanitary. It's called the ghost radar. And let's see if we can get this. And this is cool because, well, there's a coil in here that's magnetic, and when there's a ghost in the area, it changes the magnetic vibes of the area. So, okay, now we got, let's see, we let it go once. We push the button once, and it'll give you the color. The different color patterns in the back. So like right now we got blue. So that means there's a good ghost in the area. So why don't you give it a try?
So blue is a good ghost. Okay. What do you do?
You press the little button. Okay, and then you just let it go. If we see red, we take a dive.
Red is
amazing. Have you ever seen red?
I actually did. And the person was possessed.
Oh, no.
So right now we're green.
Green.
So okay. That means there's no ghost in the area.
So that's a good thing.
Well, this is amazing. So,
isn't that fun?
Did you see that?
So now there's a good ghost in the area.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, but still, there's a good ghost in the area.
Did you see that, Red?
Yeah, but it didn't stay. It's at the end of the day what stays.
Oh.
Now, if it was red, I'd be out of here like a herd of turtles.
Isn't that amazing?
This is amazing. Did you develop this?
Yeah, we developed this in Japan. And we developed this out of Japan, and... we'll be selling. These are actually going to be part of a movie. This is going to be a movie that's, you know, it starts with the ghost radar and then it develops into it. So, you know, why don't you keep this one for yourself?
And it's going to be part of Mental Scars when we shoot. We're going to have these little things here to
thank
see if
there's
any paranormal activity.
So,
that's
fun.
Oh, thank you. So, how can our fans get a copy of this? Or get one of these?
Just get in touch with you. You get in touch with me. We'll make sure they get them.
Do you have a website?
It's Ron Bard at ronbard.com. We just started it. Kelsey Grammer did the front of it. So if they leave me a message there or psychicmedia@aol.com, mm-hmm. and we'll make sure they get one.
Okay. Can you tell us about PMI?
PMI is Psychic Media International. And it's an empowerment company. It's really, everything we do is to empower people where, you know, you walk away with training when you watch it, you feel you get something out of it. Let me see if we did an example.
Okay. When did you start it?
Yeah, we just started it about a year ago, year and a half ago. Let's see if I can do this. Okay, you gotta look that way. And let's see if I can do this in a timely manner. And hopefully we'll be able to do it. So you look that way. Alright, so we'll take this.
Richard, have you seen this before?
No, I have not.
Okay.
So, like, you know, for example, you know, you try to clear your head as best you can, and you choose a number between 1 and 4.
1 and 4?
Yeah, what do you got?
2.
Is that the first number that you actually thought of?
Oh, no. Can I do it again?
Yeah, give us another example.
4.
You're killing me.
Now you're scaring me.
We did this in Asia, the last TV show, with 3,000 people, right? See, now what you were doing is you were thinking. So if I told you, close your eyes, right? And I want you to picture a black rose. Can you see it? And I want you to picture a red rose. Can you see it? Can you see the room that you sleep in? All right. You know what? What was the first thing she said? 2? Pick up that piece of paper. I thought I ripped it into 3 pieces. You were right the first time. You were right.
Oh, okay.
Where's the showing?
She was right. I made an ass out of myself.
Oh, she was?
What?
It was 2 pieces of paper. Oh. I thought I ripped it into 3.
Oh my gosh.
So you were totally correct.
You are amazing.
See, he's dance-corrected everyone.
You're the one that, you know, it's from you. You did it. Uh-huh. So when we do the shows like this, it's whenever you walk away, where you're empowered, that you've done something. Now imagine if you got 20 of those right in a row. How would you feel about yourself? You'd feel that power.
Yeah, really,
right?
Proud. Yeah.
So, we do things like that. I have a show in the works that's Are You Psychic? And it's kind of along these lines where we flipped and had the studio be the psychic, the studio audience be the psychics instead of, the psychics be the psychics, because, everyone is self-proclaimed psychic. So the best thing to do is to let the people that, really have the ability. That really just blew my mind the way that just happened.
It sounds like you work a lot with Japan and China. How did that happen?
They saw me on cable TV in Manhattan. I did a show there for about 10 years.
What was the show?
It was just a Ron Bard show, So I was like, hello, this is the Ron Bard show. And I thought I was the coolest thing ever. I'm like, walking around like that. So, people at home, they punch in the answers along with the show. And they go in the vault and they can win anything from $1 million to an old piece of chewing gum. It's like the old let's make a deal and that kind of thing. So that really blew my mind the way he did that. I gotta keep that one for me.
Yeah, this is gonna be a great show. Thank you so much for demonstrating that.
Misha and Richard, and we thought it would be a cool addition to the channel. So Kelsey and I got very excited to have him on with the and Misha with the other stars of that genre. So, it was very, very exciting. That's how we got involved, and now we're getting involved in the next project, which is a virtual magazine that you touch with your finger, and you touch one room, and then you go watch a movie. You touch another room, you can go shopping for Ed Hardy jewelry or whatever's in style at the time. And, you go from room to room by touching the finger, and it's just simply amazing. It's the most amazing technology that we've seen.
Well, so you're really famous. Excited. So how did you, I wanted to get into some of your history because it's so fascinating. You're the only psychic that's been in Forbes, but I read the story that your mother got you into psychic.
Yeah, she did. That's true.
How did that happen?
It actually happened by a burnout. I came out of the service and I had $500. I thought I was a big shot, and I went and I got a 4-door Cadillac, and I had like a little psychic burnout, a little road burnout, and I went through a house. She said, someone comes serve coffee and so on and so forth. And a woman came in, she goes, tell me something. And I mean, tell you what, she had big blonde hair and black glasses, and out of my mouth, just, I don't know where it came from. She just said, your husband got a new blue suit today. And she goes, it's a miracle, your mother's son, oh my God. And my mom came out of the room from all the commotion, and she decided to send me to Dr. Holzer, who's written 140 books on the subject. And he's really to debunk psychics. And the first prediction I made was the World Trade Center. And, you know, since then it's been an uphill, and I've been going to Japan. I go to Japan every year, spend 3 to 6 months in Japan. I do TV shows over there, and we're developing TV shows here for the States as well. So hopefully it's cool.
And how did Forbes hear about you?
Well, there was an article they were doing about this guy who was a billionaire, and I was his psychic and advisor with his corporation. I picked the board of directors and so on and so forth. And somehow they heard about me and they asked me to have an interview, and I did it. And I saw a scar on the bottom of his foot. And yeah, then he went into shock, and then it was great. So then they did the article, and then as they dug deeper, because they're really heavy fact checkers, they started digging into the president of Sega, the president of Merrill Lynch, and they were describing how I foretold the coming of the computer cell phone, the way we know it now. When it first came out, it was hard to send the photograph, you know, and I described how you'd be able to do things like buy tickets and do all these different things. And I was working for a billionaire up in China, and he said, go back and bring me back a video and show me what cell phones will be like in 10 years. And I did that, and the company spun a $40 billion market cap, and they went after it, and they, you know, started building this cell phone. So it was great.
On entertainment. I on entertainment.